हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम ऑल इन क्लास 9th केमिस्ट्री। डियर ऑल, आई होप दैट यू ऑल आर हैप्पी एंड इन गुड स्टेट ऑफ योर हेल्थ। आई ऑल्सो होप दैट यू ऑल आर स्टडिंग सिंसियरली। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर लेसन 1, मैटर इन आवर सराउंडिंग्स। In today's lecture, we will study in detail about interconversion of states of matter, effect of change of temperature on states of matter, two scales of temperature, that is degree Celsius and Kelvin, some important terms like fusion or melting, melting point, boiling point, latent heat of fusion, latent heat of vaporization, sublimation, dry ice, and effect of change of pressure on states of matter. Students, you know that water can exist in three states of matter: solid as ice, liquid as water, and gas as water vapors. If ice is heated or kept at room temperature, when you take it out from freezer, it changes into water by absorbing heat energy you supply or by absorbing heat energy from surroundings. This process of conversion of ice into water or solid into liquid by absorbing heat is known as melting. If water is further heated, it changes into steam, and this process of conversion of liquid into gas or water into steam is called evaporation or vaporization or boiling. Students, reverse is also possible. If steam is cooled, means if it loses its energy, it changes into liquid state, that is water, and this process of conversion of gas to liquid, water vapor to water, is known as condensation. And if this water is further cooled, it changes into ice. It changes from liquid state to solid state by losing energy. This process is known as freezing or solidification. So you can see that one state of matter can be changed into another. It means states of matter show interconversion. But how this is possible? What happens when one state of matter changes into another state of matter? What happens to its particles? Such type of questions arise in our mind. So we will find the answers of such questions in our today's lecture. Students, we know that three states of matter, solid, liquid, gas, differ from each other on the basis of interparticle spaces and interparticle forces of attraction. One state of matter can be changed into another state by changing these interparticle spaces and interparticle forces of attraction under some suitable conditions, like by changing temperature and pressure. So, factors which are responsible for bringing a change in the physical state of matter are change of temperature, change of pressure, or change of temperature and pressure both. Students, these conditions can only change the physical state of matter. Now, what is physical state of matter? You know that the change of state of matter is a physical change. Physical change means where the physical state of matter, that is solid, can be converted into liquid, or liquid can be converted into gas, and vice versa. Means gas is converted back to liquid, and liquid can be further converted back to solid without changing its chemical identity. Students, you just have seen that in all three states of water, ice, water and water vapor, only the physical state, solid, liquid, gas, is changed, but the chemical composition of water remains same, that is H2O. If you write ice, the chemical formula is H2O, but in bracket you will write S, solid, which indicates solid state. If you write water in liquid state, you write H2O bracket liquid state, L means in liquid state. And if you write steam, the chemical formula of water remains same, that is H2O, but along side within bracket you will write G, small g, which indicates gaseous state of water. So chemical composition of water in its three states remains same. So change of state of matter is a physical change but not a chemical change. Now let us study about the first factor of change of temperature on state of matter. What is the effect of change of temperature on the states of matter? And this factor can be explained by an activity which is given in your NCERT textbook as activity 1.12. Here we will study two cases. Case A, first of all we will see the change of solid to liquid. For this activity we take about 200 grams of crushed ice in a beaker, then we suspend or insert a thermometer in such a way that its bulb is in the crushed ice. It is surrounded by the crushed ice. It should not touch the wall of the beaker or the bottom of the beaker. Then after setting this apparatus, we heat the beaker slowly with the help of this burner. So what you will observe? You will observe that this ice starts melting. It will start melting. And also observe the reading of the thermometer. Ice starts melting into water and the temperature of the thermometer at this time is 0 degree Celsius. Students, the point to be noted that the temperature remains constant, that is 0 degree Celsius, till whole of the ice melts and changes into water. It means that temperature remains constant, and this process of conversion of ice to water is known as melting. And when till whole of the ice is converted into water, the temperature remains 0 degree Celsius. It does not rise to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 degree Celsius. It remains 0 degree Celsius though you supply heat continuously. Right? It does not, the thermometer does not show any rise in the temperature. It remains 0 degree Celsius till whole of the ice melts and changes into water. Why this happens so? Let us study further about it. First of all, what you have seen, that on supplying heat, solid state is changed into liquid state. When ice is heated, then it absorbs heat energy and the kinetic energy of the particles of solid increases. By absorbing heat energy, the particles which were at its fixed position, now they start moving. They begin to vibrate, and on further heating they begin to vibrate with greater speed, and what is the role of this heat supplied to this ice, which is in solid state and particles are tightly packed. When heat is supplied, these particles, the force of attraction present in between these particles of solid state of water, that is ice, that breaks. So heat energy supplied to this ice overcome means break the forces of attraction between the particles of solid and particles start leaving their fixed position. They start moving more freely, and when the bonds are broken, forces of attraction are broken, they start moving here and there. It means it has converted into liquid state, that is water state. So this stage is reached when solid melts and is converted into liquid. This process is known as melting or fusion. Now, melting point. You have seen that till the whole ice changes into water, the temperature of the thermometer remains same, that is 0 degrees Celsius. This is your observation in this activity. This tells the melting point of ice. So what is melting point? Melting point means the temperature at which solid melts and becomes a liquid at atmospheric pressure is called its melting point. So what is the importance of this melting point? The melting point of solid is an indication of strength or force of attraction between its particles. That shows how these particles are bonded to each other strongly. How strongly they are bonded to each other in the particular state of matter. So if that melting point of the solid is very high, it means the forces of attraction between its constituent particles are also very strong. The melting point of ice is calculated in two scales of temperature. One is in Kelvin and other is in Celsius. In Celsius scale, melting point of ice is 0 degrees Celsius. And in Kelvin scale, it is 273.16 Kelvin. For convenience, we take 273 Kelvin for solving our numericals. What are those numericals? We will see in the next slide. Kelvin is the SI unit of temperature. Students, so what is the melting point of ice in degree Celsius? It is 0 degree Celsius. And what is melting point of ice? It is 273.16 Kelvin. It's a correct value. And for our solving our numerical, for our convenience, we take round figure, that is 273 Kelvin. In Kelvin, we don't put degree, but with Celsius, we have to mention this knot, that is called degree. So, what is the relationship between Celsius and Kelvin scale? Students, you are watching that this indicates the freezing point of water, that is 273 on Kelvin scale and 0 degree on Celsius scale. And this shows the boiling point of water in this thermometer. On Kelvin scale, it is 373 Kelvin, and on Celsius scale, it is 100 degrees Celsius. What is the relationship between degree Celsius and Kelvin? 0 degree Celsius is equal to 273 Kelvin. Now, in exams, you can be asked the questions to convert Kelvin scale, temperature on Kelvin scale, to Celsius scale. So, what is the formula to convert Kelvin scale to Celsius scale? When the temperature is given in Kelvin scale and you have to convert in Celsius scale, then what you will do, you will have to subtract minus 273 value from the given temperature in Kelvin. Let us take one example. Convert 300 Kelvin to Celsius scale. Now 300 Kelvin is the temperature and we have to find its value in Celsius scale. So what we will do? We will subtract 273 value from 300 Kelvin. And 300 minus 273 will give you the value of temperature on Celsius scale. Similarly, you can find one more example. Convert 573 Kelvin into degree Celsius. So again, from this given value of Kelvin, we subtract 273 and we get answer in degree Celsius. Now students, likewise, you can solve this conversion of 470 Kelvin into degree Celsius and tell me this answer when you do your assignments, right? So now, likewise, the question can also come in reverse form. To convert temperature in the Celsius scale, now this time the temperature is given in degree Celsius to Kelvin scale, then what we have to do? This time we have to add 273 to the given temperature of Celsius, degree Celsius. Like, convert 25 degree Celsius to Kelvin scale. So 25 is the temperature on Celsius scale. We have to add this time 273 into this temperature and we get the value of this temperature in Kelvin scale. Similarly, another example, 373 degree Celsius, convert it into Kelvin. What is its value in Kelvin? So in this value of degree Celsius, you have to add 273, you will get answer in Kelvin. Again, this example you have to do on your own and answer to me in your assignment. Students, during this whole activity, one thing we have seen, and this question also comes in exam, for any substance, whether it is solid, liquid or gas, when solid is changed into liquid or liquid changes to gaseous state, temperature remains constant during the change of state. Why it happens? So, students, normally, as we increase temperature, what happens? The kinetic energy of particles increase. But once change of state of matter, means it starts melting or boiling, the heat supplied gets used up in overcoming the forces of attraction between the particles. The whole energy supplied is used up in overcoming the forces of attraction which bind the particles together. And this time, it does not increase the kinetic energy of the particles further. So, it does not show any rise in temperature and that heat energy gets hidden from thermometer. And this is known as latent heat. Latent means hidden. That is not recorded by thermometer. But it is used up in overcoming the forces of attraction and changing the state of matter from one state to another. Very, very important question. This can come in your exam. So you have to learn it. Now students, another term which we have to study during in this activity, latent heat of fusion. You have seen that ice is converted into water by absorbing energy. But how much energy is required to convert 1 kg or 1 kilogram of ice into liquid state, water state? So the amount of energy required to change 1 kilogram of solid into liquid at atmospheric pressure at its melting point is known as latent heat of fusion. So latent heat of fusion means how much energy is required by the solid state of matter to convert it into liquid state at its melting point. It's a very important question again. Now students, after studying this activity, you have seen that water at 0 degree Celsius, which is equal to 273 Kelvin, water can exist both in solid state as well as in liquid state. Why? This shows that melting point of ice is 0 degree Celsius and freezing point of water is also 0 degree Celsius. It means at 0 degree Celsius, water coexists in solid state as well as in liquid state. Now, very interesting question. What contains more heat? Now you are given ice at 0 degree Celsius, which shows that ice is kept at 0 degree Celsius. It's means ice at 0 degree Celsius shows that its melting point of ice is 0 degree Celsius, and water, freezing point of water, is also 0 degree Celsius. And both water as well as ice are kept at 0 degree Celsius. Means one is in the solid state and other is in the liquid state, but the temperature of both is same. Now, which has more energy? This ice at 0 degree Celsius or this water at 0 degree Celsius? Students, the particles in water at 0 degree Celsius has more energy. Has more energy. How? Because when it is in the solid state, the particles are very tightly packed. They don't have any space in between. But when you supply heat, the heat is used to break down the interparticle forces of attraction and create space. And that heat, which is not recorded by thermometer, is hidden in between the spaces created in this liquid state. So, which has more energy? So, particles at water has more interparticle spaces, so that energy is stored in between these spaces in the form of latent heat of fusion. So, question comes, which has more energy, particles in water at 0 degree Celsius or ice at 0 degree Celsius? So, where the interparticle spaces are more? Naturally, water at 0 degree Celsius is in liquid state. It has more spaces, and heat energy is stored in its spaces. So, more energy is there in the particles of water as compared to particles in ice at the same temperature. Very important question, it comes in exams. Now the second part of this activity is now change of liquid to gas. Now whole of the ice has been converted into liquid, and when whole of the ice is converted into liquid water and you still continue heating, supply heat, continue this contents of beaker with this burner, then after changing of ice completely into water and you supply more heat from the under this beaker, now this time you will see that the temperature start rising from 0 degree Celsius to 1 degree, 5 degree, 10 degree, 60 degree, 70 degree, and one stage will come then where it stops showing further rise in temperature, that is after reaching at 100 degree Celsius, it does not show further rise in temperature, and meanwhile this water starts boiling and changing into steam. Now again the temperature remains 100 degree Celsius till whole of the liquid is heated, boiled and changes into gaseous state or vapor state. The temperature stops at 100 degree Celsius. It remains at 100 degree Celsius. The temperature does not rise further above 100 degree Celsius. So this process means when liquid is converted into gas by absorbing heat, this process is known as boiling. And what happens at this time between the particles of liquid state? See, when liquid is heated, its particles begin to move even faster, again by overcoming the forces of attraction present in the liquid state. You can see from this diagram. And this temperature, at this particular temperature, I mean 100 degree Celsius, because we have taken the example of water, Then at particular temperature, the liquid begins to boil and changes into gases or vapor state. This process is known as boiling. Now, boiling point. The temperature at which liquid starts boiling at the atmospheric pressure is called boiling point. And this temperature, boiling point, is fixed in case of water, that is 373 Kelvin or 100 degree Celsius. You can see the conversion, 100 degree Celsius plus 273 makes 373 Kelvin. Again, at 100 degrees Celsius, water can exist in both states, that is in liquid and in vapor state. These are small questions, but very, very important objective questions can come in MCQs or one mark questions, very, very important. Again, another definition, latent heat of vaporization. This time, liquid is changed into steam. Liquid is changed into gaseous state. Water changes into steam, or liquid changes into gaseous state. So for this, there is a term, latent heat of vaporization. This time the definition is the amount of heat energy required to change 1 kilogram of liquid. Here is the term liquid into gas at atmospheric pressure at its boiling point is known as latent heat of evaporization. Students, again one question comes, very important. What produces more sphere burns, boiling water or steam? Because both have same temperature. Boiling water also has 100 degrees Celsius as a boiling point, and steam also has the same temperature, because at this temperature both water and water can exist in liquid as well as in gaseous state. Now this time you can see that if water is kept at 100 degrees Celsius, the interparticle spaces are comparatively lesser than the particles in the steam form or in the gaseous state. So now you answer, which contains more heat? Here the spaces are less, here the spaces are more. So which contains more heat? Obviously, steam has absorbed heat energy between their spaces in the form of latent heat of vaporization. So particles in steam produces more sphere burns, because particles in steam, that is water vapor, at 100 degrees Celsius or 373 Kelvin, have more energy than water at same temperature. This is because particles in steam have absorbed extra energy in the form of latent heat of vaporization. So when the steam comes in contact with your skin, it releases that energy which is greater than the boiling water and gives us more sphere burns. Very important question from examination point of view. You have to learn the reason of these type of statements. Now students, we have seen that the different states of matter can be changed from one form to another. Solid can be changed into liquid, or liquid can be changed into gases by changing temperature or pressure. But there are certain cases where solid changes directly to gaseous state without coming into liquid state. This process is known as sublimation. A change of state directly from solid to gas without changing into liquid state is called sublimation. And the reverse, when the change of state directly from gases to solid takes place without coming into liquid state, then that is called deposition. Students, you know about it. What is sublimation? When now you know winters are over and summer has started, your mother has packed all the winter clothes by keeping naphthalene balls as moth repellent, so that small germs or small insects should not spoil your winter clothes. Your mother has kept naphthalene balls in those clothes, and when summers will over and winters will start, and when you take those clothes out, will you find any stains of liquid on your clothes? No, but you feel some fragrance of those balls.
It means those solid, and when she has kept in the form of solid. When she take out the clothes during winter season, you will not see those balls in solid state. They have disappeared somewhere. So they have been changed from solid to gaseous state without coming into liquid state. This means naphthalene balls are sublime substances. Similarly, camphor you use at your homes or in hovens in your school. Ammonium chloride is another sublime substance. Iodine and dry ice all are sublime substances which on absorbing heat changes from solid to gaseous state without coming into liquid state. And this can be explained with the help of an activity 1.13 given in your books, that you take camphor or ammonium chloride in this china dish and cover it with this inverted funnel and plug this funnel, mouth of funnel, with cotton swab or ball, so that its vapors should not come out or escape from this inverted funnel, and start heating it from underside. When it gains heat, this ammonium chloride changes into solid form of ammonium chloride, start changes into gaseous form and rising up. But there is no space for its escaping out, so they start accumulating on the walls of this inverted neck of or walls of this tube of this inverted funnel. And after some time, when whole of the ammonium chloride is changed into gaseous state, just remove this burner and let it cool. You will see that these vapors will come back to solid state. So when it is converted from solid to gaseous state, there is no liquid state in between. That process is called sublimation, and reverse conversion of those gases into solid state is known as deposition without coming into liquid state. So again, this question is very, very important from examination point of view. Dry ice, solid carbon dioxide. You know, carbon dioxide is in the gaseous state, and when it can also be converted into solid state. This solid carbon dioxide is called dry ice. How it happens? So this gaseous state is converted into solid state by applying pressure. Now it is stored in the containers under high pressure. This solid carbon dioxide can be directly converted into gaseous state. So it is a sublime by absorbing heat and decreasing pressure. It will come back to its gaseous state without coming into liquid state. So that is why it is called dry ice, because there is no state of liquid. It is directly converted to solid to gas or gas to solid on applying pressure. Right? Now, effect of change of pressure. We have seen that the effect of change of temperature on the various states of matter. If you increase temperature, supply heat energy, solid will convert into liquid, liquid will convert into gaseous state. And if you decrease temperature, gaseous state will come back to liquid state, and liquid state come back to solid state. But now, what is the effect of change of pressure on the states of matter? Students, you can see that this container contains liquid state of matter, where the particles are having spaces between them, they are loosely packed. But when you apply pressure from upside with the help of piston or some weight, you see that these particles come closer and closer. They come closer. So under very high pressure, this gas change into liquid, and liquid can be changed into solid state. So by using the same process, we can also liquefy atmospheric gases. Means we can change atmospheric gases into liquid state. How? By applying pressure and by reducing temperature. Right? Similarly, you
take CNG, compressed natural gas, or LPG in the cylinders, in the liquefied form. These are in the gaseous state, and this petroleum gas, when compressed, or natural gas, when compressed by applying pressure, they can be filled in cylinders. We have learned about this in our previous lectures. So, students, you have seen that the three states of matter can be converted into various states, like solid can be converted into liquid by absorbing heat, and this liquid is changes into gaseous state by absorbing heat energy, and this gaseous state can be converted back to solid by deposition process, and reverse is also possible. When you decrease temperature, liquid can be converted into into solid. This process is called freezing, and when gas is cooled, it can be converted into liquid state. This process is called condensation and sublimation. Solid is directly converted into gas, or gas is directly converted into solid state. This structure tells you interconversion of three states of matter. Now, students, this is all for the day. Let's watch a video related to this whole topic to understand this topic once again in a better way. Thank you and have a nice day.